Students, welcome back. Let's continue with the topic data compression. So in the previous video, I explained what exactly the data compression is and why we are using the data compression. Okay, now let's see what are the different techniques or the methods of data compression. The data compression, let me write DC. DC here, it's a data compression. The different data compression methods or the data compression may be a lossless or lossy method. Lossless method or a lossy method. Okay, so the lossless methods here will be we are using the compression on text or programs. So for text or programs, it's a lossless methods, and lossy methods, it is for images, videos and audio. We can go for the lossy method. So if you are doing the data compressions on the images, videos and audios, you can go for the lossy methods. And if you are using the data compressions on the text, if you want to compress the text, compressing means you want to reduce the size. Okay, so lossless method means the data will not be lost. Whatever you are sending, that will be received by the receiver. So the lossless methods will be performed on the text or programs. Okay, so again, this lossless, the different types will be, means the different techniques will be run length is a lossless method, and Huffman method encoding is also a lossless method. And another technique here is the Lempel-Ziv. Lempel-Ziv is also a lossless method. This means one type of the compression. It's a lossless compression, data compression. Huffman is also one technique for the lossless data compression. And run length is also one type of the data compression. So that is a lossless. And lossy methods are of JPEG, MPEG and MP3. So you already know about all these things. You had seen the what is .jpg files, .mpg files, .mp3 files. You know only that thing. Okay, so here I'm saying that these methods are lossy methods. Okay, by seeing this you get a doubt. Okay, .jpg files contains the lossy information, or .mp3 files have a lossy information. Okay, it have a lossy information, but not that much. Only the unwanted data will be removed and compressed. So only the difference, but you can't able to identify what you are missing also. It's just a minute thing. If you take the images, only the unwanted pixels will be removed. If you take the video, only the minute variation, your eyes can't recognize what is the mistake there. Okay, only that type of information will be removed. That is a lossy. That's why we call these are all files will contains the lossy information, the lossy methods. Okay, so that lossy cannot be detected by the human eye also. And lossless methods. The lossless methods is the run length, Huffman and Lempel-Ziv. Actually, these are lossless methods. Means here the data cannot be removed. Whatever the data that you want to be compressed, and that data will received by the receiver after decompressed. The same data, whatever you send, means it having the redundant data. It contains redundant data. Because it is a text or programs, in the text you can't remove the letters, because you can't remove the redundant data. Maybe it will be helpful for the user, so you can't remove that. So that's why we call the data compressions. While compressing the data, to send the data from sender to the receiver, for the sake of the storage and for the sake of the data transmission, to make data transmission easy, we need to compress the files. Okay, so the files may be a text or a programs, or images, video, audio. So if you are taking the text or a programs, the text or programs, the data compression is a lossless methods. We use the lossless methods compressions, because whatever the sender wants to send, exactly that information will be received by the receiver after delivering. Okay, before compression and after compression, the same information will be there, okay, including the redundant data. So that we call it as a lossless. And whereas a lossy means there may be redundant data may be removed and that can't be recognized by the human eye also. So that is a lossy methods. Okay, so the data compression methods are of two types, lossless and lossy. So let me explain you, before going to explain the techniques, let me give the clear idea what is a lossless compression. Lossless compression. A lossless compression is the original data. Okay, it's just a original data. And the data after compression and decompression. And the data after compression and decompression are exactly same. Exactly same. Okay, so whatever the data that I am sending, exactly the after decompression is also the same data will be there. Suppose I am sending Bhanu Bhanu. In the receiver side also, you will get the Bhanu Bhanu, the same message. Okay, I am not removing the redundant data. I am not removing the letters also. That is a lossless compression. The exactly same data, whatever you are compressed, you want to send, that is before compression and after decompression is also the same data will be there. Here redundant data is removed in compression and added during decompression. So you will get a doubt, okay, if you are not removing the redundant data, how the data will be compressed, how the data size will be reduced? When only you remove the redundant data, then only the data will be size will be reduced, obviously. Okay, so the if you remove the multiple data, then only the data file size will be reduced. So without removing the redundant data, how it is possible? Let me show you. The redundant data is removed in compression. So while compression, the redundant data is removed and it will be added during decompression. Did you get it? Means at the time of the compression, the redundant data will be removed. Means the in the place of that redundant data, we are just including some numbers. Suppose A, B, A, B, A, A, like this it is there. So here A, B, A, B is coming twice. So you are just writing 2 A, B. So here instead of 4 letters, we are just writing 3 letters. Okay. So that will be the technique here. The redundant data is removed in compression and added after decompression. So during decompression, again in place of 2AB, it's right ABAB after decompression. So that is the technique of the lossless. So here we are removing the redundant data while compressing. So if you didn't remove the redundant data while compressing, what happens? The file size will not be reduced, but our aim of data compression is we need to reduce the size of the file. Okay, so the lossless methods are used when we can't afford to lose any data. So in case of the legals and the medical documents and the computer programs, we can't lose the data. So in that cases, we will go for the lossless data compressions. So the lossless data compression methods are used when we can't afford to lose any data. Okay, so this is about the lossless compression. Let me explain you about the lossy compression. Okay, so let me explain you what is this lossy compression. So I said lossy compression means there is a chance of removing the redundant data before and after the compression also. Okay, it is used for compressing images, and audio files, for all that we will use the lossy compressions. So here our eyes cannot distinguish subtle changes, so lossy data is acceptable. Okay, so in these cases, in the images and video files, lossy data is acceptable. because I cannot recognize what pixel is removed. So these methods are cheaper, less time and space. Use less space because we are removing the redundant data. Okay, so the several methods here for the lossy compression. So what is the .jpg files? So this is a compression for pictures and graphics. Pictures and graphics, we use .jpg compressions. And MPEG compression, this is used for the compressed videos. For compressing the videos, if you want to reduce the size of the video file, then you will use the .mpg. And MP3 files for audio. So this is about the lossless and lossy. The lossless means here the data, exactly whatever the data that is there in before compression and after decompression, is everything is the same. But in this lossy compression, there may be a lossless is there, so that lossless is not cause much difference while you are observing the data. So in the case of images and the video files, there is lossy compressions can be taken, that is a .jpg, .mpg conversion and .mp3. Thank you.